In this video, I'm going to show you how we use AI to create really cool graphics just like this, and then show you how we can apply those onto our garments using DTF transfers. But before we move on, go ahead and hit that like button on this video. And if you'd like more heat transfer content like this in your feed, be sure to subscribe as well. Now, there are a lot of different programs you can use to generate AI images. The most popular is probably going to be Midjourney right now. It's going to give you like really great results. But I'm all about accessibility, so we're going to use the AI feature in Canva. Yes, you heard me right, in Canva. So let's take a look. So now when you're in Canva, you're going to want to go over to Elements. And then right down here, you'll see AI Image Generator. We're going to generate our own. And there's lots of different styles that you could choose from. Some are going to lean themselves a little bit better to what we're doing today. I like keeping things kind of simple. And today, we're actually going for something kind of fun. So I want to go playful, because why not? And I've always imagined kind of like a donut shop. And one of my nicknames is Bear. Jer Bear. If you see me in person, don't call me that. But so that's what we're going to do here, though. I'm going to actually use that. So I want a cute bear eating a donut on a white... on a white background. Because we're gonna be using this for DTF, I don't wanna print a solid square. And so I already know that I'm gonna have to remove the background later in Photoshop. So I'm just hoping that this AI can help me with that. So hit enter and see what we get. Now the thing I'll tell you right now is it's gonna take a few tries to get what you want using AI. You're gonna wanna practice using different prompts. Telling the computer different things, telling the AI different things to get kind of what you want. These are not bad. These looks, I probably shouldn't have said cute, because now it looks like this is like for a preschool, like I sell donuts to preschools. So maybe we're going to eliminate the word cute. Let's do large bear eating a donut on a white background. Also, it did not give me a white background. AI is still new technology, so there's some prompts that you're going to try to put in to save you some time. May or may not work. Also, it may or may not work depending on the AI that you're using. Okay, this one's a little bit better. And what the heck? I'm going to go with this one because I know that in Photoshop, I can kind of... It's important to zoom into your work because that donut looks funky. I hate that. That's an ugly donut. If we look at this one here, this donut looks more like a real donut, but the bear got cut off. I want the whole bear in there. So let's click on this one, and we're going to generate more like this. So that was close. That donut just looks a little bit weird, you know? And that's the other thing about AI is it's not uncommon to get some weird things. AI is known for having, like, hands look weird and, like, certain things just not look the best. Okay, I already like these results a little bit better. Let's blow up this bear. Oh, still loading. Let's blow up this bear. Make him our full size. This bear's cute. It's nice and simple. This is just going to go on like a t-shirt for my imaginary donut shop. You can honestly use AI to create so many different things for different applications. Yeah. I'm going to go with this one. Looks all right. Now, another thing that we could do, and I'll show you in Photoshop. Let's go ahead and download this one. So we're going to download this one. It's still scaled up. Yeah, download. I'm just going to name it Donut Bear. There we go. So now I have my graphic. With most things in AI that you're getting from AI, you're gonna have to process it. So you're gonna have to learn how to like remove backgrounds, clean up the edges, depending on what AI you're using. Again, Midjourney is a lot more professional, so you're probably gonna get better results there. But again, since I'm all about accessibility, most of us have access to Canva, most of us can have access to Photoshop. These are a little bit more accessible, easier things to use. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and bring my graphic in. There we go. We can get Donut Bear and just drag him in. Cool. Now, one thing that is really, like, if we're just kind of taking shortcuts, And if this is going to be a logo for like a donut shop, one thing that I would do is I would just make a circle, right? And then I would create a clipping mask over that circle. And now I could scale my donut bear to whatever I want to fit in this circle. Right. It's cute. And so then I don't have to like remove any backgrounds or anything. I'm just kind of going for it with my donut bear. And then now, because this is for my imaginary donut shop, we're gonna start black text. We're just gonna start bears donuts. And I do go with the traditional spelling of donuts. I know a lot of you guys are doing like D-O-N-U-T, and I'm like, wow. I don't know what that spells, but I go with the traditional spelling of donut. We're going to pick a fun font here. I don't have a ton of fonts on this computer. There's a few that we could probably get away with. Let's find a cute font. This is a kind of a cute graphic. There we go. There's donuts. Gonna make that a little bit bigger. And then there's a stroke on my circle that I'm not a fan of. Let's go ahead and remove that. And we're actually ready to go. Now, for the text, I probably should match this color to something in my graphic. So let's just use our color picker. Maybe I want it to be pink, you know. And then also, you wanna consider the color of the garment that you're gonna be placing this on. Since I'm gonna be putting this on a black t-shirt, I'm gonna color my background black. Oh, whoops. Like I said, I'm gonna be coloring my background black. There we go. And so now that light pink font makes a lot more sense. I do wanna make sure that these things are aligned, which they were. Okay, nice. Oh, you don't know. Sorry. Let me make sure these aren't aligned. Oh, they are. Okay, great. And now this is ready to go. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do that, right? And this is just me cleaning up my graphic. Nope. There we go. And now I can save this file if I want to here in Photoshop. Bears Donuts, PSD. Even though I know it's a PSD and it'll save as a PSD, I like to name it that way. That's just a weird way that I do things. And now we're gonna go ahead and save a copy and we're gonna get this as a PNG because the PNG is what we're gonna actually send to print. Control, and then we're gonna name this print. It's that simple. Let's go ahead and send this over to our DTF printer now. All right, so we're here in the Digirip program. And so what we're going to do is just import our graphic. Very easy, very simple. You wanna resize it, of course. In this case, our maximum print width is gonna be 12.5. I'm just gonna rearrange this here so it fits nice. Actually, I'm gonna rotate it. So that way I could like really get just the maximum print because it's a little bit wider than it is tall. So now, yeah, there we go. Now I could really fit that in there. All right, so now we're importing the graphic. This is gonna be for the front left chest. And this one's gonna be a little bit smaller. So it's the same graphic, I just imported it again so I can make it smaller. Usually I'm at about like 4 inches or so left to right on that one. Sometimes it'll go 3 3/4, usually about 4 inches. We're just gonna give it a little bit of space from our other graphic. So that way we can, it'll just be easier to separate after we powder and cure. That's pretty much it. I'm getting ready to print this now. So with my mouse, I'm gonna drag and select both of these files and click print. And you'll notice that it's going to print the color first, and then of course it hits that white later. The white gets laid over our color graphic, so that way it'll pop and look great no matter what color garment we're using, especially though because we're using a black t-shirt. And there we go. Once it's done, we're just going to feed it out a little bit, trim it off, and take it over to our powdering station. Now for this project, I am using my DTF station Seismo Shaker. I really like it because it applies the powder nice and evenly in that nice little waterfall that you see there. And then of course you just turn on the shaker and it's going to shake off all the excess powder. So it keeps everything nice, neat, and clean and really even and consistent. And we bring it over to our Phoenix curing station. Now I love this oven because it has the built-in air purification system. So you put your transfer in there, 60 seconds later you pull it out and it is done. All right, we're just gonna pop this onto our t-shirt, make sure it's positioned properly, cover it with parchment paper, and press. Now because we're using the DTF station universal film, we're pressing at 315 degrees Fahrenheit for 15 seconds with a medium to medium firm pressure, and this is gonna be a hot and immediate peel. Next up, we're gonna do the exact same thing on a smaller scale because it's time to press our left chest logo. Now, because I have my DK20S, I'm able to thread it so I don't double press the back. That feature really comes in handy. And there we go. And there it is. Our t-shirt is now done front and back. What's crazy is that before this video, this logo did not exist, and a lot of that is thanks to the AI that we used in Canva today. Of course, couldn't have made this shirt possible so fast without DTF printing. If you'd like to learn more about DTF or purchase your own direct-to-film equipment for yourself, head on over to heatpressnation.com.